now we're dropping in on the Tangerine Trail. We should call it loop. They should include the other side with it. This is the trail that kicks my butt. This one and the one coming back. Again, just over there on the other side of the road. Because there's lots and lots of freaking whoops. And everybody knows whoops are my weakness. Being a short guy, short legs, it definitely, definitely a challenge. But I try my best. Whoops, whoops, see? Look at these suckers. Hate them. Yeah, I actually don't hate them. They just wear me out. I mean, I bitch about them enough. But it's good to practice them. Hopefully keep getting better at them. Of course, at 50 years old, I don't know how much better I'm going to get. Getting up there in the years. I'm a little long in the tooth for this kind of stuff. We're getting better anyway. Seeing my buddy up there, Mr. Beers. He's good at these whoops. He gets to run like it's nothing. Big tall son of a gun. Got 4 inches on me in the height department. Yeah, I'm only 5'8". There are people all the time talking about how short they are. Like, you know what? My bikes are not... I never lowered a bike ever. Matter of fact, this KDX is a lot taller than what it was from the factory. Because of the KX250F show of twin chambers I put on the front. And the RM125 show a shock on the rear. Whee! I should have made videos of that when I installed that stuff. I think it would have been informative for some KDX owners. So we'll see. Maybe one day off. I'm going to blow this bike apart. As soon as I get my gas back on, up and running. So I'm gonna redo this bike, make her look nice again. I like my bikes looking nice. I'm a big fan of good looking bikes. Those guys are cutting the course big time. Cut off that corner. Really, guys? I understand skirting the whoops and stuff, and chops. You don't cut the trail, all right? You're cutting the trail, you know, you're wanting to be a racer. Let's find during a race. When you're practicing, you know, sorry I'm saying that a lot. But when you're practicing, practice what's there. That's what makes you a better rider. Not freaking, you know, damn, I did it again, you know, you know. Oh, I hate when I, hate when I do that. So I apologize. This racer's getting pulling on me because I start getting my legs tired from this. All these whoopies. That's okay. Yes. Jumping up and cutting a whole new line. To me, it's not helping your skills. It's not helping you to be a better racer. Alright? You're just cutting out the technical, harder stuff. So what, you know, so how does that help you, huh? It doesn't. So you're just actually hurting yourself. Yeah, I know you guys, most of you guys can do that. But out here, are way faster than I am. And that's okay. But you know what? One thing I've noticed is those guys that think they're fast, and they are in this, like this stuff right here, they kill me. I cannot keep up to save my life. But the same guys, when we get into technical stuff, I'm eating them alive. And you know why? Because I'm a damn good technical writer. At least most of the time. Not always. See, he's pulling the gap on me now. My butt out. There. Whee! Remember when that was a big dangerous rut? The rain has finally loaded it down to where it's not dangerous anymore, which is nice. I'm gonna try and catch up with my bro. Like I said, he gets me in this fast. He gets me in this fast stuff. He's much better riding that loop crap. I'm not. I'm sure being on a short wheelbase KDX is not helping it, but I just need to be, I need to be more confident in it. Like most things, confidence is everything. And I admit, I don't have confidence in the woods. You think as good as a rider as I am on technical stuff, or I should say, I'm not great. Trust me, I'm no freaking Graham Jarvis. Alright, nobody. I'm nobody like Graham Jarvis, Billy Bolt, Johnny Walker, none of those good guys. But I'm pretty damn decent. Like I said, lots of fast guys. One of our buddies that me and Beers helped educate on riding, he's a mid-20s guy. He's now in the A class. Couldn't be more proud for him. He will flat out smoke my butt and stuff. Guess what? I still beat him, even though I'm a 50-year-old mid-pack B-rider, when we get into the nasty stuff. And that makes me very happy. It shows I do have some skills. He's worked so much on going fast that he kind of needs to slow down a bit, work on his technical skills. He's a damn good rider, but it shows you, you know, that's where he could do some improvement. Everybody's got places they can improve. You honestly think Graham Jarvis, in my opinion, the Billy Goat, best ever off-road racer in the world for technical stuff, and you know, you aren't gonna tell me there's somebody better than him. Guy in his mid-40s now. Oh, thanks, Rock. You know, he is the man. Yeah, those guys are faster than him. He tries. He knows he ain't gonna make it up fast. And guess what? He's a hell of a technical rider. And he knows how to ride that tech stuff. And Mr. Graham Jarvis, like you said, or I said, you know, the best in the world, arguably. Mr. Jarvis practices, working on his skills, till this day, shows you that we all can be, you know, make some improvements. I know I can. Gotta get my whoops down. Need to get better still with my front brake. Front brake, I still have to consciously think about a lot. I don't like that. I'm trying to get to where it's unconscious. I haven't got there yet. Sometimes I it is, or it is, but not most of the time. Keep working on your skills, guys. Whatever it is that you hate the most, work on it. To the point that you actually like it. At least you're better at it, where it wastes less of your energy. You don't dread it when you come to it. Whoops are the only thing that really stress me out other than heights. But that's a whole nother different thing. Heights don't have nothing to do with my skill. So, damn these whoops. They're relentless in spots. Here comes a nice section right here. He's always killing me. Every once in a while I feel brave enough to hit those at speed. Not very often. You know what I mean? Look at this. Whoops after whoop after whoop. Luckily the ribs are feeling a lot better this week. Took some ibuprofen before we left the house. Hopefully ease them up even more. Trying to make them loose, not hurt so much. And seems to be helping so far. Might need to go one stiffer on the rear suspension. I think I'm just a little soft. See those whoops? I skirted around them. But you know what? I hate these things. But guess what? Here I am, you see me. Every week. Riding these doggone things. Why? Because I need to improve. That's how you get good. Not just riding the stuff you like. You're riding the stuff that you hate or you're not good at. Work on it.